Fantastic to have you here with us at the London MCM Comic Con. Have you been enjoying it so far?
Oh, it's been great. It's just been great. Obviously, it's really well attended. I understand it's grown hugely, even year over year. And the fans are just lovely and so kind and so excited to have us here. So it's been really delightful.
What are the most common questions you've been getting from those excited fans when they meet you?
The most common question is, can you give me a spoiler for Once Upon a Time for third year? And I keep saying, you know, I can tell you... right at that moment, we don't know. They won't tell us, of course. So,
I guess, starting with Once Upon a Time, the show's obviously been a spectacular success. What do you think people have responded to so well about it? Why do you think people love this show so much?
You know, what they've been able to do is, I think, in the best sense, capitalize on characters that we already know and love. So we have a history with them already. And what they've then done is very sort of smartly, intelligently, and sort of thoughtfully created a new story around what we already know. So it's almost like, you know, if we know the melody of kind of what the characters are, they're jazzing against that melody. And it's created this kind of wonderful engagement by people sort of all ages. I have families come up to me and say, it's the only show that my whole family can sit down and watch. My 8-year-old and then my mother, who's in her 80s, both watch this show and are both equally engaged. So it has somehow been able to be sort of maintain a level of intelligence and sort of something sort of really unique and different and with a fresh spin on characters we all know and love.
Talking about your character, what specifically excited you about that role?
I don't know getting Jiminy Cricket as a character was never something that I imagined would actually in the, you know, like, this role is going to come to you one day. I never imagined that this would. That said, once it did, and perhaps, you know, several other people felt this way as well, but because it's such a fan favorite, because it's sort of an iconic Disney character, it also sort of felt like big shoes to fill. Like, holy cow, I hope I'm not going to muck this up, just because it's... so many people feel so deeply about it. That said, again, the writing kind of gave us a real, they gave him just a wonderful, dark, deep, sort of sad story background. And a lot of people came up and said, oh my goodness, I didn't realize that was Jiminy Cricket's backstory. And of course, they made the whole thing up. But it's a testament to the writing. Honestly... I love the character. He's a good man, and he's clearly been through a lot to be the man that he is. There's a difficult sort of struggle that he's had to get here. But that said, they have given him this. A lot of people come up to me and say how much they. I was so sad. I was so sad when I thought that you were dead, and then. I feel like somehow they've been able to sort of use the affection that they have for these characters and then just sort of basically expand on it in a way and make it more.
Of course, I mean, fans will have their own favorite characters. Apart from your own, are there any other particular characters? I mean, so many iconic ones to choose from that you'd especially identify with or just enjoy watching or working with.
Yeah, I mean, I love Robert Carlyle. What a great actor he is and a good man and really just a brilliant actor. So, I mean, those are great. Those are great scenes. Those are great moments. And I love watching him as well. I really enjoyed the Pinocchio character. I really enjoyed the Man in the Mirror. But there's so many, and there's so many yet to come. You know, they have for sure a very big canvas with Once Upon a Time. They can go anywhere, can't they?
They really do have unlimited options. For you personally, though, where would you like to take, particularly your character, and I guess the series overall, what kind of territory would you like them to keep exploring?
You know, there's... I have so many... You know, I think we all have our vision of the show that we have in our head. And I don't know... You know, clearly, it's Adam and Eddie's vision, and I know that this past year was a year about bringing in a lot of new characters and really sort of expanding the canvas. I know that there's a core group of us who are sort of in Storybrooke, and that I've gotten a lot of sort of feedback that people love those characters as well. So we'll see how they can sort of begin to mix us back in and sort of comb us back into the story in a way by expanding the canvas, they have also then, you know, some of us who are at the sort of center of the story are absent at the moment, and maybe there'll be opportunities to bring us back.
Final question before we release you. Do you have a message to Once Upon a Time fans watching this everywhere who can't wait for season three? Anything you'd like to say to all those lovely people?
Oh, goodness. I wish I could tell you what was going to happen. I don't know. At the end of the day, what I can say is that there's a lot of very passionate, thrilled, and sort of committed artists, writers, directors, actors who are so excited to be a part of this. And it's been an amazing journey. I mean, it's incredible, the reach of Once Upon a Time across countries. And I hope to find you on Twitter. And for sure, there's a lot more in store. There's a lot more Once Upon a Time on its way to you.